welcome back to some match fishing. I can't believe it. It's been 3 months. Finally, I'm on a match. It's the 30th of March, 2021, for anybody who's watching this in the future. I'm just sitting in the car park at Acorn Fisheries. Normally you can park behind your peg, but they're having some work done, so they're asking people to park in this little car park. That's fine. The excitement of getting back into match fishing was short-lived because I've managed to draw myself peg 22, which isn't a fancied area at all for framing. On top of that, it's going to be very, very busy with every peg in. I mean, at the moment you can see lots of spaces, but that's because I got here early for the draw, and the draw is quite long and drawn out so that we can stagger it for COVID regulations, etc. So I have turned up with just pellets. I've got micro pellets, 4mm pellets, 6mm pellets, 8mm pellets, and all hard, obviously. And I've got some expander. And the plan was try and work with those. And there was always a backup plan, which was if I drew an area like I have drawn down here in 22, there is a silver's pool to fish for, but also it's more of a can I just catch some fish today? So I've got some ground bait with me, and when the tackle shop opens, I should probably pop down and get a pint of reds, pint of red maggots, so that I can catch everything that swims. Still going to start it positive and have a look for some carp. You never know with these weird weather. The carp move around. You know, you don't need many carp here to frame because there are some big ones, and it can all happen in the last hour. But there's a lot of good anglers on here, and there's a lot of better pegs than me, so the chances of me doing anything fantastic are low. So I'm going to be trying to film this. I've not filmed a match before, not with any success anyway. So maybe not having a busy day will help with that. So anyway, guys, this is the intro done. It's for my first intro for a match. So wish me luck, and I'll catch back up with you later.
Wow, didn't even have time to feed. I was just trying to work out where my spot was. Trying to work out exactly where my spot was that I'd fed. What I plumbed on. And it's just gone straight around. That was ridiculous. I put my rig out there and I thought, whereabouts did I plumb up again? I was trying to find my marker on the far banks. So there was a bit of grass, and I've changed my glasses and I can't see properly. And the elastic just came out. I was like, oh, there's a few there then. Well, hopefully. We'll try again. smaller, a little stocky this time. Fishing in about 18 inches of water. Just tapping a few. I thought there were 4 mils, but there might be big 4 mils, and might be more like 5 mils these. Slightly wetted. Float just keeps going under every time I go out there. That's 3 in a row now. Another small little 5-1. It's quite small for the stamp that you would expect from Acorn. A little stocky. Well, 5 or 6 pound in the bag already. Size 14, quite a nice big up. 6 mil expander. Now the Sonia Bates Pro expanders that Des likes. Just putting probably what 10 maybe in there every time at the moment. 10 little. Elastic is a little bit fierce for those last two fish, but I was expecting a bit bigger stamp, so I'm just going to keep working through these. These keep coming like this all day. That'd be amazing. I don't think they're going to. Bring in there. Slip that rig into where they've fed them. And if you pick it up on the camera, if you can see the float or not. Real positive bite, split's just gone. Fish there because the float's moving left and it's moving right. Now it's moving left again, that's just fish moving around feeding. There. Yeah, it's going better already. I wouldn't expect to have this many fish in the net. I wouldn't say I'm flying up, running away with it. There's plenty of people catching, looking around the place. It's could be a decent weight affair today if this keeps up. You may not be completely properly up. Normally they're subdued by now. They're really waking up now. This weather's good. I'm hoping that this is a real munter. Looks like it is a decent one. Some real nice big commons in here. Go into. He's hooked in. I think he's either wrapped up or he's hooked in the front. In the front flipper. I don't think he was originally. Maybe the hook's pulled out and gone into the flipper because he came in really easy. He doesn't want to play the game now. Just trying to see if I can mug him in. I'm not fishing super heavy, I can't pull his head off. Or his fin off as the case is in this scenario. Definitely foul lock now, he should be subdued by now. Oh no, he's not foul locked, he's in the mouth. Must have been wrapped up. Oh, lovely. I'm going to have a little flip of that because he's a bit lively. He's a little lively in there, isn't he? You stay there, big boy. That's what we want. These are the ones that we want to catch with an acorn. You can sort these ones out. You can frame. Oh my word. What have you been on? I'm going to give myself maybe 9 for him. Just to be cautious on the clicker. Right, it's just over. I think it's about an hour and a half in now, maybe hour and 20. I've had that better fish, I've not really had anything else. I've had lots of fish coming into the swim and giving me indications. Can't catch them. I don't know if there's too much bait out there now or what. I've not got a lot in, but there's fish coming in and out, but they're not taking much. So I'm just going to drop back down the shelf again. This is my first put. Dropping back down the shelf. Catch a few skimmers last time I did this, but just see if we can put something in the net. Whilst we let that far line settle again, I might go back up there. You can see there, I don't know if you can pick it up on the camera, but there's a swirl up on that back line now. No, now the pole's not in there. The fish, something's in there munching on those free offerings. So let them thin out those free offerings a bit. And then hopefully when I go back over there, more likely to get a bite. This time when I tried this, I had a couple of liners straight away on this shorter line. So it's big carp, they come off that back line and just stay shallow and just bump into your line. It's a nightmare. Acorn's a nightmare for liners up in the water. Little indication there at the moment. Could be a liner, could be a skimmer, you never know. Just waiting for something more positive before I strike. It's quite hard for everybody now, and there's not a lot of get coming out. So I'm not in a rush to try and make anything happen. That rig's not settling at all now. Lay it in properly, maybe it's up the slope a little. So I'm on a slope there. Well, about 5 minutes ago, you saw me come shorter onto that slightly deeper line. Just dropped some, I thought, I had a couple of indications, but it didn't really turn into anything, so I just put some micros on it. And I've had this pretty much straight after the micro's going in. So 30 seconds to a minute later, I've had this, expect the float's gone under me, expect it to be another skimmer because that's all I've caught from this line so far, but it seems to have bought in. A carp, he's not massive. I'm on lighter elastic on this one, so this is the Duraslip 11, for anyone who's not used it before, it's brilliant. So, I think this is a carp, unless it's a big tench, could be either. chance of going and seeing it yet. There he is, it's a carp. Oh, nearly knocked him off there, didn't I? Carried away. Nicely hooked in the corner there. We're going to give ourselves another three. Three, we got three. He's not quite three, he's probably a bit more than two. Proper one on. I think it was a proper one. I saw him for a second. Hope he's up properly in the mouth, because I'm fishing in shallow water over there, you never know. And what seems to be happening, working for me at the moment, this is like the third fish I've hooked and three puts. I lost one and the other one was a small carp. He's been quite aggressive with a feed, must say aggressive, that little tiny pot on the end there, just filling it every single put. With micros and not staying out there for more than 2 minutes before coming back and feeding again. It seems to be working well for me. I'm getting bites really quickly if I'm going to get a bite. I'm still fishing an expander on the hook, it seems to be the best way to get the bite. So. Yeah, see if we can. Yeah, this looks like he's up properly and looks like he's decent. This is going to sort of add another 50% to my weight. It's only got about 20 pounds, so if this is a near double fish, maybe 8 or 9 pounder, that puts me straight on 28, 29 pounds. And that's what I'm saying about it. You've got to get them big fish in here because I've had a number of fish and I've if I land this, I'll have £30 and £20 of it, it'll be two fish. So there are proper lumps in here if you can get through to them. He just doesn't want to come up here, big boy. There he is, he's had it off. £8 perhaps. Behaving a bit better than the last lump that we had. Invariably in this lake they're commons if they're this big. There's very few mirrors. A little leech. Leechy thing. I'm catching them on the koi's hands. It's at 013 bottom, believe it or not. I'm having no problems. Not with this elastic and then 6mm expander. I'm filling the pot up. If you can see that over there, I'm filling the pot up with micros like that. walking back in there. Oh dear. Oh, it's a bit bigger than I thought it was, it might be six. Pulled out into his fin. Pretty sure he wasn't fin hooked. He's borderline five. So we'll go for five. And a clicker, so there we go. Decent fish from over on that right hand swim there. It's pulled it down until he's ready to net. Little scrappy 2 or 3 pounders that I want so long to get in. It's the worst size, we've got power, just enough power to cover the problem, not loads of energy. I just like a sick, I'll play out, I'll break the line.
Yeah. Sorry if I swore there, guys, I'm not sure if I did, I think I might have. A little bit frustrated with the little wiry guy, isn't he? It's 2 or 3 pounder. Right, guys. 20 minutes left. Still catching on that right hand hole. I had to come off and on and off it a few times. I've just had this one out of that right hand hole. And so I've gone back onto the first line that I caught a few fish on earlier. Another one off there. trodden the margin down to the left again with fin. I've trodden the margin down to the right. It was really hard to get through all of the scum on the surface and I didn't really get any bites. So I've just stuck with these two fine lines. They want absolutely bagging, so if I keep fish coming, I'm competing on these fire lines. I don't need to catch short. There's another little three pounder. Two or three pounder. I'll give him three. If that was a roach, you'd say he was three, wouldn't you? Got 84 on the clicker, so I'm somewhere between 80 and 90 now. It's not very good at the clicking. Still doing the same. I'm going to alternate these two swims for the last 20 minutes. Unless one of them stops producing altogether. Seems to be working best at the moment is on this line that I'm on now, this left-hand line. Micro seems to work better through the cup. Seems to want just like a little cup of micros snuck in. And on the right, they seem to want the 4mm dart splashed in. They're coming to the noise on that right-hand one, so maybe they're fish there. Under the bridge coming out, or maybe they're fish that are high in the water and just following it down, need a noise to trigger them off. I've changed my pot because I've lost my other pot, it fell off. I've lost two pots today. I'm on my homemade ones, which I like. It's not very good for sprinkling, but I'm not using them for sprinkling. I've done my ones with lids on today really because I'm bouncing them out a lot. I've lost my two little pots today. When I'm going here I might not even have anything in there by something like that. Knocked most of them out already. It's really scummy over there. It wasn't like that when I first started fishing it. It's going to be hard to make sure that the bait's gone through. It's all gone through now. The float's sat down nicely. So you fed right on top of the float, and that's what you got to do. You've got to leave the float bang there and just wait. If you ain't had a bite within 2 minutes, you're probably going to get one on it today. Some days you have to wait longer. Today. Some days it's incident, but today it's been sort of like 1 to 2 minutes. Oh. A little tiny dink on the float there. Up with. I've got 4 pounder, isn't he?